Ukraine drones attack refinery after a warning from Putin.
Iceland declares state of emergency after volcano eruption.
Dean Bien ban blooming season.
Hello everyone, you are watching today's news on NTV channel. My name is Chen. Let's get started. Russian officials confirmed only this morning that a fire broke out an oil refinery in Slavyak in Russia Krasnodar region following multiple drone launches by Ukraine into the area.
Local media said at least four Ukrainian unmanned aerial vehicles, UAVs, were destroyed on the flight to Moscow in the early of March 17. Fortunately, no damage occurred and no one was injured in the areas where UAV debris fell. Moscow accused Kyiv of using terrorist activities to try to sabotage the three-day Russian presidential election, scheduled to end March 17. Previously, President Vladimir Putin said on Friday that Ukraine would be punished for trying to disrupt the Russian presidential election by shelling civilian targets in Russian territory and using 2,500 armed soldiers to try to pierce Russia's borders.
The 2024 National Press Festival officially concluded on March 17th in Ho Chi Minh City after three exciting days, with the theme Vietnamese Press Pioneering Innovation for Revolutionary Cause of the Party and the People. The festival showcased the professionalism and modernity of the Vietnamese press.
This year's festival attracted more than 100 booths displaying typical press products from 63 provincial and city journalist associations, more than 300 central and local press agencies, and journalism training establishments. In addition, the event took place with professional seminars, many in-depth discussion sessions, strengthening connections and exchanges with journalists, interacting and enjoying activities, increasing the closeness between the press and the public, between journalists and readers, TV viewers, and radio listeners. At the closing ceremony, the organizing committee awarded many awards to the units such as Impressive Exhibition Booth Award, Impressive TET Television Program, Impressive TET Radio Program. Gayan Radio and Television Station won Award C for Impressive Radio Program and Consolation Prize for Impressive Television Program.
Southern Iceland was once again hit by another volcano eruption, leading to the declaration of the state of emergency in the Reykjanes region. This marks the fourth eruption to occur in this area since December.
The eruption created a lava flow estimated at 2.9 kilometers, while released satellite images showed the volcano spewing orange smoke and lava into the air, making the night sky glow bright. Icelandic authorities had to declare a state of emergency in the area. The eruption took place less than a month after 4,000 residents were allowed to return home after being evacuated due to the volcano's eruption on November 2023. The eruptions also raised concerns over the Svartsengi power plant, which provides electricity and water to about 30,000 people on the peninsula.
Coming up next are some updated news.
The 500 kV Circuit 3 line project is a key and urgent undertaking, playing a crucial role in national energy security, particularly in the northern region. In Nghệ An province, two projects under the 5 kV Circuit 3 line are currently underway. Firstly, the 500 kV Quảng Trạch Quỳnh Lưu line project, with a total investment of nearly 9,800 billion VND, covers a distance of over 82 km passing through Nghệ An province. Secondly, the 500 kV Quỳnh Lưu Thanh Hóa line project, with a total investment of more than 4,000 billion VND, includes a route passing through Nghệ An province, spanning approximately 17.5 kilometers. The approval of the measurement map for these projects' compensation plans has been mostly completed. Localities have committed to handing over the corridor to the investor.
The International Watercolor Painting Exhibition, the largest of its kind in Vietnam, opened on March 16 at the Temple of Literature in Hanoi. The display presents to painting lovers more than 200 artworks that were selected from more than 400 pictures of 60 artists from countries and territories. This is considered the largest watercolor painting exhibition in Vietnam, contributing to the development of Vietnamese fine arts. The exhibition brings art lovers unique collections of watercolor paintings from different countries. The event aims to promote community spiritual and cultural values, gradually turning the Temple of Literature into a creative space.
An Olympic running day for the health of all people 2024 was jointly held by People's Committee of Gay and Province, Department of Culture and Sports. The event drew the participation of nearly 3,000 officials, people, students and 150 athletes participating in the provincial cross-country tournament. At the launching ceremony, Vice Chairman of the Provincial People's Committee called on all officials, people and students to choose a suitable sport and participate in physical exercise, following Great Uncle Ho's example.
In the warm spring weather of March, flowers in the northwestern mountains and forests bloom again, adding to the nature's majestic beauty. Let's appreciate the beauty of banff flowers in Điện Biên.
As March arrives and the weather gradually warms up, the northwest mountains and forests once again burst into a radiant display of white daylilies adorning the hillsides. Banff flowers symbolize the beauty of Thai ethnic girls and have long been an integral part of the cultural and spiritual life of the northwest people.
We often attach the image of banff flower to the promotion with the meaning of the Dien Bien Phu victory. The banff flower blooms again on March, which is also the day associated with the opening victory of the Dien Bien Phu campaign. Maybe that's why many places also have beautiful banff flowers, but banff flowers in Dien Bien and events associated with banff flowers are conditions to attract tourists to Dien Bien.
During these March days, along the roads leading to Dien Bien Phu City, across the backs of passes, and atop mountains, one can witness the landscape blanketed with white banff flowers. Anywhere can become a stopping point to capture the wonderful moments of Northwest Spring.
This is first time I come to Dien Bien. When I come to the banff festival, I see that the banff flowers here are very beautiful. Many tourists from nationwide come here to see the banff flowers. I feel this is a great tourist destination.
Come to Dien Bien during these days to immerse yourself in the pure, romantic beauty of the flowers, intertwined with the rich culture of the people here. It becomes a captivating highlight in the idyllic yet alluring northwest landscape, leaving tourists longing to return.
This is the end of the show today. Thank you for watching.